this series of videos, you will understand more of what it's like being a pilot. The life as an airline pilot is affected by many outside factors, such as tower operations, maintenance, check-in process, and more. Our host and guide in this series is Lars Nauer.
Welcome to Arlanda Tower. This is the largest airport in Sweden, and we operate around 750 movements, takeoffs and landings every day. We have three runways, and normally we depart on one runway and we land on one runway. And this evening, strong wind from the south, we operate with 190 left and 190 right, they are called, and that's the direction of the runway, 190 degrees. And we have a third runway, and it's located in direction 0826, but it's not using this for the moment. Normally we have around 4 to 6 people working at the same time, depending how much traffic. Just this moment it's a bit low traffic, so we have only 4 persons working, and we don't have any kind of problems with the weather more than strong winds, so it's a quite normal operations. And to help us to manage the traffic, we have some equipment here I can show you. We have this first equipment here, it's called the ground radar, where we see the traffic when it's on the ground. The blue is the traffic going out to departure on the runway, and the yellow here is traffic who has landed and taxiing into the gates at the terminal. You can also see if we have any cars or other vehicles out on the taxiway system or the runway. And this is necessary to have when it's foggy or the visibility is poor. Is it good visibility? Like this evening, we look outside and see with our own eyes how the traffic is moving. But we still use this as a help to decide how we manage the traffic when it's much more traffic than it is for the moment now. And when the traffic is in the air, we have this. It's a radar also, where we see the traffic when it's airborne. And also here, the yellow one, they are the traffic going in to land at Stockholm Arlanda, and the blue one is traffic departing from the airport. And you can see the direction of the runways, where they're going in and going out. And as I said before, this evening we are departing to the south due to the winds. And you can see traffic also around Arlanda Airport, going into Bromma or just passing over our airspace. And on the third screen, we have the lighting system for the whole airport. And here we can choose which runway we want to be lightened, and the taxiway, how we want the lights to be, in which direction they are taxiing. So depending which runway in use, the taxi is lightened certain directions. And we also have the possibility to see how the weather is around the airport. And we can see the weather radar, where we see if it's coming snow or it's if we have heavy rain. And of course, in the summertime, when we have a lot of thunder and lightning around us with cumulonimbus, big clouds give strong winds and who we want to avoid. And we can see where they occur and how it's moving. That's a very good help for us to plan our job here.
Scanning 169, good evening, pushback approved. Speedway 781, Charlie Taxi 2, Holland Point, runway 19 right, the taxi via X-ray, hold short to Sulu Lima.
Du, jag har en fråga här på den här.
Den här är han får ju gå till sex,
ja.
Om jag ska ställa honom och vänta här, eller tror du att jag ska ställa honom här? Det är ju den här som kan vara.
Ja, vi hade nog ställt den på X-et. Så att liksom. Sen skulle vi kunna be att du skickar en rea i och att han är pushad.
Ja,
det skulle vi faktiskt kunna göra. Nu taxi jag SAS där nere från 41.
Left-hand 805, good evening. Start up approved according to slot 1820. Clearance Frankfurt Nostri 4 Golf. Squawk 7313.
Lock 45, good evening, push back approved. Vehicle 781, Charlie, continue taxi, hold short of Yankee. Taxi 169, contact tower, 118.5. Speedway 781, Charlie, go behind the sub 2000 coming from left on Yankee. Exit 884, taxi to stand 5-3, uniform golf and uniform.
Hello, 69, hello, Skinny 169, wind 190 degrees, 1 knot, 2 knots. Runway 190 right, clear for takeoff.
Briefing 489, taxi to stand 148, via Viskan, Sudo.
We are working 24 hours a day and 365 days a year. Never closed, always open.
Up in the tower for a while. You've been showing us the tower. Thank you very much for letting us up here. It's not very easy to get up here these days due to security and everything, and it's also a very important working environment, so they don't want to be too much interrupted. And now we are down in the cafeteria actually for some questions. CMAC had some questions for you.
Yeah.
I first want to ask you, do you think the relationship with the pilots are working?
Normally they're very good.
Okay.
Normally we take care of them. I think it's working fine.
Yeah. What is very, very nice is when you can do things like this and when you can go flying with us. So then we can usually cover the little things that makes the other part annoyed. So it's information, knowledge, and also a very important thing is stress. So when people are stressed, then they can say things that they regret after that. But generally it works out very well. I mean, we've been in this business for so many years now, so the routines are working quite well.
Working for the same.
Exactly. Oh yes, absolutely.
Safety.
Absolutely. Safety, yeah. So see, like, you can come up here and because you fly the simulator on the PC, and then on the simulator on the PC you also have an air traffic control.
Yeah.
Okay.
So and then you have a microphone and speakers and
so you have a virtual controller.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
So one of my questions is, where is the nearest ATIS? Where is it based?
The ATIS is on the airport here. Quite least a bit off the airport, but at the control center for they are managing the ATIS. But in this building, just below where the tower is situated, they are actually the one who is operating it, just typing in the information of the ATIS.
Mm.
So
and you used to have ladies employed for that purpose, and remember sometimes they used to fly with us, and they took their job very seriously. And some had a very bad dialect, so you couldn't basically understand what they were saying.
Now like the 80s is a computer voice,
right.
So you can have a dialect there.
And you have one 80s for departure and one for...
Exactly.
And then we can also get them through data link, which is very nice also. Mm.
And my other question is, how tall is this air traffic tower?
It's 83 meters, so it's the tallest one in Sweden.
Mm.
Alright, and how many takeoffs and landings do you have every day?
Around 750 up to 800.
Okay,
takes
a lot.
Yeah, but it's a bit less than when we had the... We have had, actually, the largest number is 999.
Oh, really?
For one day.
Uh-huh.
But that's more than 10 years ago, but we didn't reach 1,000, but
amazing.
But normal operations today is around 750 up to 800.
Wow.
Mm. So how many airplanes do you land per hour in
Well, we normally call it the capacity, and it's overall capacity, and that's 84 movements an hour.
Right.
That's both landing and takeoffs, of course. And then normally you have more landings and less departure, and then it's changing all the time. It's 84 on the average hour.
And now the winter comes. I saw that you had a competition there. About when the first snow was going to come.
Yeah, and we're discussing if the snow have already arrived. Or
right. It was the other day.
Yeah,
in a
but
shower.
We say it was all rain.
So
with some snow.
Right.
Yeah.
So the criteria is when the snow actually sticks to the ground.
Yeah, exactly. We say so. We will have summits later in the snow. So
That's when things really get complicated. When you have snow removal, you have maybe wind limitations, and then you have the de-icing of the aircraft. So then we have remote de-icing platforms so that you can de-ice as close to the runway as possible.
Yeah.
But then things really get hectic.
Then it's those days you don't want to work.
you have to be very patient.
Yeah.
So did you have another question?
My other question. Third question is that how many radars do you have in this area?
Radars?
Yeah.
Well, we have for the ground radars.
You look much better than I do. So.
Well, on the airport for the ground movements we have 3 radars.
Okay.
And for the area up in there we actually have 2 radars. One is Uppsala and one is situated around. So that's for our. But the area control has a lot more radar stations situated around.
It's like New York.
Well, yeah.
And then those radar pictures are being computer merged so that you get sort of picture.
So the coverage is best.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
And then you also have a weather radar, we saw that.
That's
so you can see thunderstorms.
Yeah, SMO in Swiss.
Oh, okay.
There, using their picture.
Because that's very important when there are thunderstorms in the summertime, and so that we can get an idea of. Well, of course, we have our own radar, but it's nice that you have it as well.
Yeah.
So I think I don't have any questions anymore.
Okay.
So
I hope you get your dreams and become
okay.
A vampire.
Thank you very much, and thank you for your questions, answers.
Yeah. Answers. Yeah.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Welcome. Thank you.